We went to the Courte Oreilles Community College.
Amin, cousin, how are you doing?
Ed.
Bonjour.
The overwhelming generosity and welcoming spirit of the people of this tribe has been without bounds. Every place we've gone, we've been treated like family. The college has this huge farm that's actually been a farm for decades, but it has not been in use for many, many years. It's about 90 acres of usable farmland. And they've integrated this into a sustainable agricultural program. We got to go there and meet the farm manager, Sue, and her assistant or accomplice, Chris. One of the earth-shattering moments I had is that she took me into her seed barn, and she has jars of heirloom Native American seeds that she has traded with people in New Mexico and people on the East Coast, all different varieties of flint corn, blue corn, all these different beans and just native foods.
So why do we not see more agricultural?
There's a couple factors. One, the ecosystem didn't like really support it. The second was, if you go down south, you'll see a lot more agriculture.
Right.
Just because we're on that border, we have such a small growing season. Ojibwes, they were much more family oriented. People would be in smaller family groups and be going for chicagawanch, or the wild onions, or wawagoggins. There's a couple other things that you can harvest right now that would be foodstuffs. And then here in a month or so, everybody would start going to berry picking grounds because
hunters and gatherers.
Yep.
Because this farm hasn't been cultivated for years, the soil is dead. So what their main focus is at this point is rebuilding the soil with compost and chicken manure and different sorts of amendments, keeping it 100% organic.